Hi, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails, and in this video, we have taken the whole 16, yes, 16 long Alice in Wonderland tutorials and condensed them down into one video for you. You can still watch the long versions if you wish, or you can just watch this snippet. So I've prepped the tips. I'm just going to use a wide brush to apply. Prepare the brush first, so I've gone into some water, wiped it off so it's slightly damp. Then we're going to go over the top. Keep going backwards and forwards. This is purely a background. So we're going to use Grape Expectations on the top here. It's got that little bit of shimmer that I want. I'm going to deepen the colour slightly as well. With each nail, once you have buffed it and removed the shine, you need to wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution. So if you saw I was sketching out, what I'm going to do, split this up into 10, made a very rough sketch of what I'm going to place on these nails. We're going to sketch it now onto these nails. I'm just going to go back to the original picture and my lovely smash phone and just have a little look at them so I can see exactly what I'm working with. I've got a rabbit here. I want him quite close to the bottom of the table, well, to the top of the table. Need to get the proportion right with the head, because the head is very large. Make that a little bit more prominent so it's a bit easier when you come to paint. So we're just laying down the background colour for the face. Let that dry. So I'm just mixing a blue to match Alice's dress. Now his eyes are actually a soft pink. You create these long eyes. So use the brush to create the strokes of the fur, so just using the brush to do little tiny strokes like this is going to make it look more fluffy. With a slightly darker grey wash, I've gone round the glasses and round the eyes. And you see his shirt here under his bow tie. You'd get a shadow there. Got to think about where the light's coming from and where the shadow would be. Still lighting it a little bit more. And the hair will follow onto this next nail. It falls right to the shoulder. And you even see it. Also going to come here. Go as close as you can to the face. Just going to use a wash that I made with a little bit of black, a touch of yellow, which makes it more moody. So come around the ear and I just shape the ear nicely. And then also shadow into the hair. I'm just using that black wash to add the little eyelashes. You've got to get the eyes right. You don't want to look like she's got one eye going in one direction and the other eye in the other. They need to be both looking in the same direction. So we're going to use a little bit of black with a lot of water and use that as a wash. Now we're going to move on to the Mad Hatter. With the white, I'm going to make a little bit of a wash. Going to do some highlighting his eyes. Going to do his pupils. So I'll put the white in there for his teeth, and then we're going to separate the two front teeth. Same colour as I've used for the inside of the mouth. On the original Alice in Wonderland, he has white hair, but I'm giving him orange hair, just like the new Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland. I'm roughly going to go over with a bit of brown. And his jacket runs down here. You can leave the space for the dicky bone. Just using a whitewash to highlight the buttons a little bit. Don't forget, we're going to have a big 3D dicky bow here, so don't worry too much about here. They're coming along nicely. Also with your wash, I want you to roughly mark out where your eyes are going to be, where the mouth is going to be. Now we're going to do the eyes. I've just gone through the middle of a mouth, adding some tiny creases to the lips. Do the same puffy shoulder. Fade. Just going to contour her waist. Same with the other side. We're using the dotting tool, starting from the middle, working your way out. Is just add a little bit of purple, just in case you still see a little bit of that. Okay, for the next part of this design, we're going to do the Cheshire Cat, and it'll sit just here. And you need to map it out so you know where everything sits, so you know that you've got room. So with the lilac, I'm going to paint the entire shape. I'm going to do a nail at a time, so I'm really controlled. You don't need a brush that's too fine. I mean, it's small, but it's not mega small. Just going to use some white to bring out his eyes. So I'm just drawing that bit of, I'm painting that bit of fur. With the black, I'm going to water that down and go all the way around the outside. Just adding a little bit more on this. There we are. You can see what that shading and highlighting does, especially to his body. Basically, more three-dimensional. The next character that we're going to do is the caterpillar. I was going to do him small here, but I really think he needs to be slightly larger here. So we've got top of his hair, his face coming down, his body here. The base colour on now. There's no detail at this point. Now he's quite a simple character. By that I mean it's not too detailed. So the profile of his cheeks, edge some parts, and also map out the features of his face. We've got his nose, he's got a really simple nose. Just add a little bit of shading. Like I say, he's quite a simple character. He hasn't actually got a lot of detail. Now, he's known as the smoking caterpillar, so we will add some smoke to it as well. I want a really diluted wash. This will create your smoke. So you're going to put your wash on and then just start to work the edges. All I'm doing now is just adding little bits of smoke in the background. So that's the caterpillar finished. What I'm going to do next is define this table here. I'm going to go across with white. I'm just wetting the brush and smudging that down. We're going to edge it with black. Now we're going to add some shadows from the people that are sat round the table. So you're going to roughly mirror with the shadow what's in front of you. So that's all the shadows done. We can move on to filling the background.
So we're going to paint. I'm going to paint love hearts. I'm going to do a diamond. So as these dry, you'll see that they get quite dark, and that's what we want. We want them to just sit nice and dark in the background.
And that's just added a little bit, and that's all it needed. I was looking at it and I thought, you just need something else.
I'm going to apply Mega Gloss Sealer Gel.
We're ready to do the 3D work and any embellishment work that we're going to do. So I'm going to start by doing his hat. So I'm going to do the main body of it. We can see where we've mapped out where the hat's going to go. Put that on. Now I'm going to push it where I want it. I'm just blending this and getting a nice smooth finish by putting quite a wet bead over the top and just sort of painting it over. I'm going to do this in little sections. Doing this top part, well, this corner end, I suppose, here first. I'm pressing into the powder to create a dip, as if it's coming and curling around. And I'm going to press it down a bit and then flick it back up, because we want to create some movement. And in between here, we will put his little ticket. So I'm going to place it there. Pick up your bow. Place it on. Now we're going to do Alice's bow. I'm going to fold it over. Same with this one. And I'm going to join them together a little bit. Pick it up. We can see that fits really nice. For the next bit of 3D, we're going to do the little rabbit's pocket watch, and it's going to sit here. Just sharpen the edges up. I'm just whipping the brush around the edges and drop that into it. And then another bead on top. It's going to go here. Now we're gonna pop it on. It looks really nice. The dangling chains look cool. And it just adds something extra to that nail. The caterpillar, the smoking caterpillar, we're going to do his little shisha pipe. This is a bit like baking. It's a little round bead here. This is just gonna add some detail to the pipe. Before the length of the pipe sets, I'm going to curl it. I'm just curling it around my finger. Just sit around there. With some clear acrylic, I'm just going to put one side of it here. Now I'm going to add a little bit of decoration with some paint. Now I left this space here, and if you remember me saying it was for a teapot. This is going to be the main body of the teapot. With some of the pinky purple. That needs to set up a little bit. Press that down. A light blue bead, flatten that out. So we're going to put another bead here to do the very tip of the spout. Just building that up and blending it in. With the blue, the darker blue, I'm just going to put a tiny bit inside the frill just to bring it out a little bit more. So we're going to do a cup and saucer directly onto this. First of all, I'm pressing in to open this out. And do the handle, pushing into that bead to open it out. Like she has a cup of tea. We're going to do another teacup here. We're going to do them all different. It's pretty much the same principle though. Placing the bead on, patting it out into a basic shape that you want. You can slice through. Going to open this out, pressing inside and pushing out. And I'm going to pop that there. Not on the edge. clear acrylic.
Yeah, it's starting to look like a tea party now. On this one, I'm going to do a little cupcake. So we want a similar shape that we did the cups with. So I'm going to pull some lines through because this is the little case that the cake is in. I'll just literally pull through to create a bit of movement in the buttercream. I'm going to do a cupcake on here as well. Just create a bit of a swirl. I'm going to do the queen of hearts, her own individual cup. I'm just having a look at this now to see what can go where. So as I look at that, I want something here. I'm going to put a little mark there so you can see. Here. Here. And here. And here. So what I'm going to do with the knife and forks and spoons is literally glue them straight on. I'm going to make some cards. I'm going to adhere the tiered suits that I've made. Just let the cards sit on top of the acrylic. Simply going to glue some stones right at the end. I'm gluing them on rather than using the Mega Gloss sealer gel. I'm going to put some around the outside of this spade. Wow! I'm finished! Okay. So, it's been 3.5, roughly 4 days, and it's finally finished. Oh my God. I hope you enjoyed the short version of Alice in Wonderland. If you want to watch the entire series, click this link here. There. And you can give it a watch. I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails, and in this video, we have condensed down all 16. I was going to say My Little Ponies. Alice in Wonderland.